Hello, 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 hello. Greetings, 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 listeners, friends, frenemies, everyone. It is Wednesday, and it is time for a Wednesday word of wisdom. You know, I'm always intrigued by the lessons that life continuously teaches us. There are those moments that bring us to our knees. There are those moments wherein we celebrate. Every gamut of emotions we can think about, we have probably experienced them throughout our lives. So I felt it just appropriate to even go ahead and record today's Wednesday Word of Wisdom, because I just feel that there is a message. There's just a message in life in general. And so today I have a question for you, and I want to ask you, what are your plans? What are your plans? And so a very familiar passage of scripture in Proverbs 16 and 9 says, "At the heart of a man plans his way, but the Lord establishes his steps." The Lord establishes his steps. And so this really spoke to me and it resonated with me on today. I had a doctor's appointment that I had to come to, and en route, I had a flat tire. And but fortunately, because I'm fortunate to have multiple vehicles, but I happen to be driving on the vehicle that does not have a spare tire. I didn't know that. But then again, I recall from the last incident when I had a spare tire, and I was like, but I thought I had one. And so when I asked the question, like, what are your plans? Because we can always have things planned out. I had a doctor's appointment. I had taken today off. I was going to go shop and, you know, get some things for the house because I don't get out much. And so was going to go get an adjustment at the chiropractor. I mean, just I had plans, right? I had plans today. But here I sit, still in the parking lot, stranded. At the doctor's office, my appointment was at 9:45 this morning, but I am still sitting here. But guess what? For a moment, I was going to give, I'm not going to say the enemy take my joy, because nobody can take anything from me unless I give it to them. But, you know, for a moment, I thought I was going to give the enemy my joy, but then I had to smile and think about, you know, so many blessings that came out of that. So even though I had plans, you know, and I had things on my mind to do, there are so many blessings in that. You know, my husband is off work today. You know, he was at the lake doing what he loves to do. But yet and still, you know, he's dropping that because he's going to come and see about his wife, you know, as he should. And then, but I, you know, I was going to find another way, right? There's always a plan. You know, you just have to just move and strive. But he said, I'll be there. As I sit here and wait for the tow truck to come and get my car. Had another call earlier where, you know, the technician, as he called himself, showed up to try and at least change the tire. And that is when I discovered that there was no tire to change. Again, I had a plan, but that plan didn't work. But the blessing in all of that, as I sit here reflective, because I have nothing but time, right? I can't go anywhere. I can't do anything. But I can sit here and I can just give God thanks and praise, one, for having arrived to my destination safely. Do you understand me? There's nothing like pulling off on the side of the road and traffic is coming at you know, just to and fro, at speeding by. Big trucks, you know, as I sit there in the emergency lane, nerve-wracked, right? Because I've got to get out of the car and I've got to look and see how much damage. But all in all, you know, it does cause us to a point of humility and reflection. And so I'm just grateful, again, grateful to be safe, grateful to have the means to go and get, you know, get another tire or tires or whatever the case may be. I still have my health. I still have my life. I still have my mental faculties. And just, you know, hey, what else can I say? So it's not even about my plans. No, maybe I can't shop today. And perhaps there's a purpose. You know, maybe I could go to that store that I was going to, and, you know, maybe that store could be held at gunpoint. I don't know, right? I mean, because there are so many things that are happening in the world today, and we just have to make sure that we stay aware, and that we do have a plan. So when I ask us for a plan, we do have to have a way, right? And so I just, you know, wanted to take a moment to just, one, just to share my, just the testimony. This just happened today. You know, I was going to teach about something totally different, but that's why when our steps are ordered by the Lord, you know, He will direct and guide our paths. And so I love even in Proverbs 3:5-6, where it tells us that we cannot lean to our own understanding. We must trust in the Lord with all our heart, our soul, our mind, our will, every fiber of our being. We must trust in the Lord, not leaning to our own understanding, but in all of our ways, acknowledging Him, because He promises to direct our path. Listen, I am so glad that God directs my path. And He can only do so if we live a life submitted and committed to Him. And so we need to check where we are. We need to check, you know, what it is that we're, our thought processes and our responses even in things. Because again, quickly, I could have gone there and been like, you doggone enemy, you know, or I wanted to say something else and probably have this morning. Let's just be real about it. But when we check ourselves, then and we find ourselves in an humble position, we're in, we've still got to give God thanks and praise. And I was talking to my granny, I call her, and she'll be 97 next week, and she was just saying, you know, I just hate that you're going through it. You're so sweet. And I was like, and I always tell her, I get it from her. But I told her, even in one, she said, but I'm glad that you're safe. And I said, that's right, Granny. I said, the most important thing out of this eventful morning, not the best doctor's report, you know, with that, but even in that, you know, I am still giving God the glory, because I know that there's nothing I can do, regardless of what the situation is. I can't change it. And so but I can change how I react to it. And so I just want to encourage y'all for a minute, you know, and ask you, you know, what's your plan? Like, what do you have planned? But think about that. I really want you to ponder that question, because, you know, as we move throughout these days and years and months, as we, you know, 2020 was tough. 2021, it's proven to be interesting, and first few months haven't been the best. But guess what? There's still a silver lining in all of that. And God has given us, He's prepared us, you know, for those that will listen. You know, the messages are coming, they keep coming. And so I want to make sure that even as I ask that question, I'm saying, what is your plan? Like, I'm thinking about a plan and have made plans for my family, for my household. That's all I can control. I can't control anybody else's. But if the heart of man plans his way, but the Lord establishes his steps, if I continue to allow God to establish my steps, no matter what my plans are, guess what? The Bible says the steps of a good man or woman are ordered by the Lord. And so I want to keep stepping. I want to keep stepping in cadence with Him and with the Holy Spirit. I hope you can hear my finger snapping, because there is a cadence to this thing. And you have to pick up that rhythm in the Spirit, and you got to be willing to walk in stride. You got to be able to move, you know, as the Spirit instructs and commissions you to move. So I want you all to be encouraged. Thank y'all for indulging me as I shared a few moments about what your plans are. Thought I had mine today. They all busted up. But guess what? God is still going to be glorified. Amen. I love y'all. Thank y'all for listening to the Wednesday Word of Wisdom week after week after week. Thanks for liking. Thanks for sharing. And thanks for subscribing. All right, until next time, God bless you.